You're listening to episode 176 of The Art of Living Big. Today, I have a guest on the show who I have known for many years. Heather and I met through some entrepreneurial channels several years ago and just kind of kept in touch, you know, online like you do. And then back in the spring, she became a client of mine. We're going to talk a little bit about that and what happened to her, because sometimes life gets really difficult. And Heather will tell her little story when she finished coaching with me what happened. And I believe that if you can see it in the way that Heather sees it, which is that there's purpose for things, that there are lessons in things, that there is a little strain of gold through all of the muck and yuck that you have to go through. So her story has been unfolding over the past week, and I asked her this morning if she would jump on and just sort of share with us, because I just think it is such a hopeful story, and the way that she sees the world, I think is really great, and it's part of what I teach, you know, to help people to see, like just like last week we were talking about, is the universe testing you or is it training you? So you can choose which one it is. So anyway, we'll get to the show, but if you want to hear a little bit more about how I actually work with clients, what the five shifts are that I use to help them make these shifts in their life and go from like where they're kind of feel stuck and kind of mediocre to a life where they are really growing and living and becoming something more. So you can find that just by going to my website. Just go to betsypake.com. And if you have been there or you've been following along for a long time and you think that you're ready to make some shifts, you can jump on my calendar. We can talk about it. I can see if I can help you get some clarity and if I might be able to help you do that. You can find my calendar just by going to betsypake.com/letstalk. But I think a great place to start is by watching the training, just so you kind of see how I work and what I do. All right, y'all, without any more noise, we're going to go right to the interview. Welcome to The Art of Living Big. I'm your host, Betsy Pake. I'm an international expert in manifesting from your subconscious. And this podcast is designed to help you think differently about what could be possible for your life. Now, let's go live big. Hey, everybody. Okay, so I'm excited today for today's show because I have a really special guest. And I'm just going to introduce her. I'm just going to tell you her name, and then we're going to just start talking. So this is Heather Filipowitz. Hello, Heather.
Hi, friend. Hi, Betsy.
Hey. Okay, so I wanted you to come on today because you have a really crazy story. I don't even know where we should begin. Where should we begin on this?
I don't know. I guess maybe let's just start by you and I, right? So,
okay, yeah.
We've known each other just sort of on the interwebs and in each other's inboxes for a couple of years now, right? And then,
yeah. And you were a guest on the show, like early on.
I was.
And at that point, you were doing something like a little bit different than you're doing now, right?
Yeah,
would you
I've
say?
I've always been a writer. Yep. I was the theme of my writing and the theme of my website and what I was doing with it is very different from today, but it's all mm-hmm. part of the process, right? Of figuring out our path.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, that totally, was still a fun interview. I mean, it's still neat, right?
Oh, yes, totally. Yeah.
Very much who I am. And then a couple of months ago, I had my breakthrough call with you, and I signed up for coaching with you for, mm-hmm. I don't know, for that month. I don't even remember what month it was.
Right.
April
it was,
or May.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. Eight magical weeks together.
Yes. It was a huge leap for me, but it was, oh my gosh, so smart. I just sort of had that feeling that that was the thing I needed.
Right.
We had our first call together, right? Our call.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's really, I think that's really where this story begins.
Yeah.
So it was our very first week together and we did a one-on-one call.
Yeah.
And we do this really magical implantation into your subconscious of what it is you want to manifest.
Literally getting goosebumps now just listening to you talk. This is so fun.
And
Yeah, it's so powerful. And I remember we just had such a really good session. Like it felt so energized and like next level, like we were moving beyond, right? Beyond who we really were. Yeah. And in that, I asked you to pick a date because I wanted to implant a date where you knew everything's basically moving forward, like everything's falling into place. And so we picked the date, and now you kind of tell.
Yeah. So you pushed, you know, this dream, this vision, this, which I know will come true with all my being. It seems really far away. And then you said to me, well, I want you to pick a date 5 months from now. And I thought that was nuts, but you pushed, and I was being coachable, right?
Yep.
So I picked October 17th, 2019, just off the top of my head, because it's my parents' wedding anniversary, and you said October. So I thought, all right, we'll pick that date. They're sure. Let's just see what happens. And then from there, I put it on some of the things we had worked on that date, my key phrase of who I am, on my mirror in the bathroom. I had it on a note on my desk, and I just, you know, kept doing the work and showing up and doing the things we're supposed to do, right?
Yeah. Right. And you did. You were showing up for everything and doing all of the work. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And then all hell broke loose.
And then you finished coaching. And then I'm not even sure if how I first found out if it was like Instagram or if it was like you might have come into the private Facebook group for the coaching clients. But you were like, there's this bump in my floor and it keeps getting bigger.
Yeah. And it... the bump in my office floor turned into close to $50,000 home renovation, pack up your family in a week, have to pull up all the floors, not covered by insurance.
Yeah. So like it was totally disorienting thing. So you kept seeing this bump. And then you were like, we got to figure out what this is. And I don't know the pieces of this, but you were like, I got to figure out what this is. And I don't know if you had somebody come look at it and you realized that really there was a water leak, right? That had
There was water under the house. Yeah. From the ground. And then we drained that. And then as we pulled up our floor, we realized our subfloor was completely rotted through and there was holes underneath brand new floor. And we just moved in.
You had just moved. Yes. You had just moved in. So all of a sudden you're like, our floors are our subfloors are rotten. Like we have to pick everything up out of our house. Like not like we'll take what we need. It's like you had to move every piece of furniture, everything.
Literally everything in the span of a week. So we packed up the house, filled the pod, got a hotel reservation and moved the husband, the wife, the dog, the 12-year-old kid into a hotel, which is where I'm sitting still right today.
How long have you been there?
Since September 1st, and today is October 10th.
Okay.
And so, you said to me through all of this, which really was truly, it's excruciatingly hard. Yes, there are worse things in life, of course, and we have many blessings, but it is extremely hard, financially scary, like all of the things.
And like you work from home. It is your home. Right. And it's your home, your sanctuary. You hadn't been there very long. You have a dog. So you're like uprooting the dog. You have a kid that's young. And so he needs his space. Like, you know, all the things.
It's
you
hard.
Work from there. And,
and yet there's still this growth mindset. This, I know that there's good in this somehow. And my intuition kept saying that there's a reason for this. And you had said to me, this is really hard stuff. So you rest. You rise, you repeat, and rest, you rise, repeat. And I used that a lot on the really hard days when, you know, it was, the money is just pouring out, you know, and it's been really, and energetically, you know, I'm so sensitive and it just felt so overwhelming at times. So even when I wanted to be thinking about the big dream, I really had to just get one foot in front of the other and get through the day.
Right.
You helped me see that in a lot of what you and I, you've taught me. And
Well, thank you.
Mindset work is really important in times like that.
So, right? That's when it, that is when it's, you know how at Easter time you get those chocolate bunnies? And every year we would get our chocolate bunnies and I would just squeeze the hell out of it. And my mom would be like, why are you doing that? And it's because I was trying to see if it was a hollow chocolate bunny or a solid chocolate bunny. And I think that you are a solid chocolate bunny. Squeeze you and squeeze you. And you've got the foundation that is solid, right?
Yeah. Yeah. So here we are, getting to the end of the construction. And so yesterday we were, pushing the contractor a little, just saying, mm-hmm. All right, let's get some dates. And I said, and I'm not looking at the calendar. I'm just thinking of, okay, so today is Wednesday, Thursday, what are we looking at here? So yeah. I said, let's give him Wednesday of next week, the deadline. He's pretty much there anyways. And then Thursday, I'll have the cleaning crew come in, it will move the furniture back in, and then we can check out on Friday and sleep in our beds for the first time on Friday in a clean house and the furniture's in. All agreed upon. All set, ready to go.
Yep.
Perfect. All via text with the husband. So I pull up the calendar.
Yep.
And Thursday of next week is October 17th, 2019, the date you and I set.
Yeah. I get cold chills every single time you say it.
It's truly magic. And what I said to you in my text was, so this was supposed to happen all along, whatever. Yeah. And you had said to me through this whole process, maybe this is the reorganization. Maybe this is everything has to shake up in order for you to rise up to where you are going.
Yeah.
And deep down, I sort of believed that. Like my intuition was said that that's true. That's hard to believe in the middle of it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yesterday when I saw that calendar date, I knew you were right. It affirmed everything that like my gut instinct told me, like that we had to go through this.
Right. And you have a big dream, right? You have a big dream. And I was talking on the podcast, I think it was last week, about are you being tested or are you being trained? And you are being trained. I don't believe you're ever being tested. I believe you're being trained for what it is you want. And I think working with me.
I listened to that episode and I was nodding the entire time.
Right. Correct. Yeah. Yes. And I even think working with me I think it is that for everybody. Like I come into your awareness, you decide to take the leap because it's all on your path, right? And hopefully people aren't fearful of their path and they take, they trust their intuition and they take that leap, but you did and it prepared you for this training so that I can hardly stand it. I can't wait to see like what happens to you over the next year because I think that really amazing things are coming because it's like you're all set up now to launch. Everything has aligned and everything is perfect.
And the other interesting thing about this time has been I've been really creative. I've written more than I ever have. I launched services because, you think, well, boy, I better get some money, extra money coming in to pay off for this stuff. But it was already half done anyways. So I was like, well, if now's the time, there's less fear. What is everybody going to think? I can't worry about that.
Yeah.
Now is the time. I have everything I need. I everything is falling into place. So I best do the work and get it done.
Yeah. And, so tell everybody what you do, what you launched.
So I launched services. So I'm a yoga teacher. I'm an intuitive medium. I'm a Reiki practitioner and I live in Tampa, Florida. So I launched in-person services and virtual services and just really writing more. I mean, writing is my thing too. So the creative blocks just sort of disappeared. There was my mind couldn't tell me no anymore. I just had to believe and do because I didn't have a choice.
Yes. Well, I think fear keeps people from doing a lot of things and the worst possible thing had already happened. So it was almost like you were able to shove your fear aside because you're like, I have got to move forward. I have no other choice. There's nowhere else to go.
Right.
Yeah.
And I'm doing my family a disservice and myself a disservice can I bring in extra income to pay off the loan and move us forward financially? Sure, right. Can.
Yeah,
and
right?
It's what,
yep,
I wanted to do anyways. So it's almost like, well, if I'm at the bottom, I'm just going to bring myself up.
Yeah.
And I really
rise, rest, rise, up. Repeat.
Yeah. Rest, rise, repeat.
Yeah.
And it's, so that was, has been so eye-opening for me. So now that date, I did, it's not like I, you know, when I first thought of the date, I thought, I'm not going to get a book deal on October 17th, 2019, because
right.
I want to be, yeah, a published author.
Yep.
No, yep. I'm going to be the strongest version of myself, mm-hmm, who really has no more fear.
Yeah.
And is full steam ahead now.
Yeah.
So that's,
yeah,
what that date means. It's my fresh, clean slate, my fresh, yeah, solid, secure house. My root chakra is strong, like all of it.
Yeah. Of you showing up, now you're showing up as the person who can have that dream.
Yes.
Yeah. It's
and
so
awesome.
And
you know, I'm painting the house with all beach color, beach house colors. You know.
I love it. I love it.
That's where I'm going next, sister. We could get, yes, one next door to each other.
I think we should. I think we should have, like, even a lot of the people that listen to the show, I sometimes they'll message me and I'm like, oh, we should be friends. And then I'm like, maybe we'll have a whole street with all of us. We can all have... It would be the greatest street ever. All my
but
friends.
I have looked at, I keep looking at them. I go to Zillow once a week. Just
oh,
to
I go to Zillow. Absolutely. I'm all over Zillow. Yes.
I love it when the dot says I already looked at that one.
Uh-huh. I have so many saved lists. Yeah. And then if I get really creepy, I go to Google Earth and see if I can like zoom in and see what's
same.
Actually going down. Oh my God. That's
but
awesome.
That's how we do it. We're painting a vision.
That and is so, how you do it. Yes. You get clearer and clearer and clearer until it has right. to become yours. I'm so yeah. super proud of you. I think you're such a rock
thanks.
Star. And I think that you have taken the very worst that can happen and figured out how to create something that will influence and impact the rest of your life. And that's not an easy task. And I'm just, I'm so proud. I can't even stand it. Thanks for sharing your story.
Thanks for being my coach and my buddy. I appreciate it so much.
Yes. Love you, girl.
Love you too, girl.
Thanks so much for listening to this episode. If you found it of value, please share it with your friends, tag me on Instagram, or leave a review on iTunes or any of your listening apps. If you leave a review and you take a screenshot, please email it to us at support@betsypake.com and we will send you a self-hypnosis audio that will help you break down any limiting beliefs that you have. So thanks so much for sharing. Thanks so much for leaving your review. And don't forget to join us inside our Facebook group by going to theartoflivingbig.com and I'll see you there.